Over the last decade, malicious emails have begun to employ increasingly sophisticated methods of deception. In the old days, an email attack might have very clear signs that it was malicious. Perhaps a person posing as a long-lost relative, for instance, who's notified us of a recent inheritance. But since then, attackers have leveled up. And in today's video, we're going to look at three variations of an email attack. These are hypothetical attacks. They are reconstructions based on real malicious threats that Antigena email has neutralized in the wild. We will see that it is increasingly difficult, bordering on impossible, to rely on the human eye alone to spot the difference between real and fake. Fortunately, however, in circumstances where an email attack would bypass both the legacy approaches to cybersecurity and our better judgment, self-learning AI stays a step ahead of the attackers. If you are new, welcome to the Darktrace YouTube channel. We are the world's leading cyber AI company and the pioneers of autonomous response technology. My name is Mariana Pereira, and I am the Director of Email Security Products at Darktrace. The first step in any attack is reconnaissance, to identify a vulnerable target and explore the best ways to exploit it. The attacker is probably looking for a single point of entry, and we know that over 90% of attacks start with an email. So when attackers are crafting a spoofing or an impersonation email, reconnaissance will include thorough research of the individual or company that is to be impersonated. My colleague Max Heinemeier, Director of Threat Hunting at Darktrace, is an easy man to find online. As we see, a simple search is enough to surface plenty of information of our friend Max, including photos, articles, social media profiles, blogs, videos, and so on. So let's say an attacker is looking to impersonate a known individual, let's say Max, and to target someone, let's say me. They could craft a fake email, such as this one we're showing you here. How can we tell that this email is fake? Well, if we didn't know it was beforehand, perhaps we wouldn't notice. But here we see that my name is actually misspelled, Mariana with two N's instead of one. And we can also see some typos littered throughout the email. Moreover, here the sender is using an email address that appears to be a personal or a free account rather than a business or a corporate domain. And these accounts can easily be created through any number of well-established providers and may be used for legitimate communications. But it's unlikely that your work colleague would use it to email your work account, and therefore this looks suspicious. However, without prior context or any expectations, this sender might have deceived someone who is less familiar with Max's day-to-day communications, especially if they added a photo to the account setting. The recipient's underlying trust may lead them to let their guard down. Now let's look at another variation of the same email. Here, the copy has no spelling errors or typos, and looking at the sender address, it appears to be from a corporate or a branded domain, which was likely purchased and then registered. But the bulk purchasing of domains is relatively easy to do by legitimate businesses, as well as by hackers, who are buying their way into the inboxes. The domains used here is one that has not been used before, but for people unfamiliar with the sender, they might not be aware of this, or they might not notice that the domain is a lookalike or spoofing a legitimate brand name. Additionally, the email has a hidden hyperlink, and hidden links might be a sign of malicious intent, as the recipients may trust the sender implicitly, and so might not hover over before clicking on the link to see what it is. Again, here we must honestly ask ourselves, if in the flurry of the constant and fast-paced email communications we receive, do we have the time or the mental bandwidth to actually check and hover over every link in every email? Okay, now on to our final email. How can we spot that this isn't a real email? Well, let's look at the domain. The domain used here is antigena.com. It certainly seems legitimate, and perhaps even for people familiar with Max's job, where he works with leading innovations such as Darktrace Antigena in depth and on a daily basis. Hovering over the link, we actually seem to be going to a legitimate website, but legitimate websites are still often used to host malicious content, as we've discussed in our video detailing a watering hole attack. The point here is that even for somebody familiar with Max Heinemeier and familiar with digital deception methodologies broadly, they'd still have a hard time sensing that this was suspicious with the naked eye alone. And so let's take a step back and think about the influx of emails streaming into our inboxes on a daily basis. Though the emails we looked at today become increasingly difficult to identify as fake, it is hubris to rely on humans to catch every single case. Considering especially how chaotic and fast-paced many of our lives have become, we cannot rely on humans alone to overcome the natural yet ever-present threats of human error, as we're constantly clicking through e-commerce receipts, newsletters, solicited and unsolicited emails, and of course, legitimate work correspondence. We are increasingly relying on technology to automate routines, drive real economic efficiency gains, and it virtually underpins every aspect of business operations and our daily lives. So to keep pace with this ever-growing persistency and variety of threats, It has never been more important to augment our security teams and leverage self-learning AI to regain the advantage. To learn more about Antigena email, please click on the links below in the description. Remember, you can reach out to us over LinkedIn or Twitter or at youtube@darktrace.com. Please remember to click on the subscribe button before you head out. Thank you and see you next time.